Hello Star Wars fans, I'm Flaghead.net Fig Review. Still on the Star Wars Lego for 2012, and this one is this. This is Droid Escape Set 9490. Let me just zoom in there to give you a better picture of that. So again, another highly anticipated set because of these two guys, the Sand Troopers, and we get a same R2-D2 and a slightly different and modified C-3PO. And this shuttle, the Escape in a New Hope. That's the box. You can see on the back, there's the shuttle itself and a canopy, and R2 and 3PO are inside. Nicely done, and you get a little speeder bike with these, with one of the sand troopers, which is kind of cool. So that's it for the box. Inside the pack, one standard instruction manual, lots of usual bits and pieces in building the set, and I believe at the back we have. We have a little bit of comic that has been added in there. 3PO and R2 in the shuttle plummeting down to Earth, and it lands, and that's them running away from the sand troopers. Obviously it didn't happen, but there we go. Some other sets which we have in stock here and we'll be reviewing. The X-Wing, the TIE Fighter, the Geonosian Cannon, this one we're reviewing right now, and the other two sets. So all of these are up for review on FlyGuy.net on our YouTube channel. So have a look and find out whether these are worth your money before you go and buy. That's just a quick look at some of the mini figures that are available so far this year. And again, we'll give you a good look at all of them in HD as usual, so you can decide whether you really want these guys for your collection. Really looking forward to some of the droids and the zombie Geonosian and the Jack Porkins, the plump little X-Wing pilot, so looking forward to seeing that. And we'll also have a review of this set for you pretty soon, the Star Wars Battle of Hoth set, which is on its way. So let's start off with the droids and this droid escape shuttle thing, whatever you want to call it. So blasting off from the Tantive IV and the New Hope, R2 and 3PO are inside this, which then lands on Tatooine, and the escape, and well, you know the rest if you've watched the movies. Nice little piece, some lots of kind of bits and pieces and that move and so forth, but ultimately it's all pretty standard stuff. When you open up in the canopy and get it the right way, there we go, you get R2 and 3PO inside, manning some controls as they fly down to land on Tatooine. Oops. There you go, and if you've ever watched our videos, they're all in high def. Choose your settings on YouTube and you can get to see all this crispy in whatever format you want. If we have a look at 3PO, he's slightly modified from the previous versions. He has a different torso print. Let me zoom right in on that. There we go, sharp and clear. Different torso print on 3PO from the previous versions. It's subtle, but it's enough there. And the eyes, they never had... it was just a plain face before, but they've managed to put in kind of lighter yellow paint in the centre of the eyes to make a difference to the minifigure. So again, even though this 3PO has been out many times, it's now a different version and enough to make you want to buy it again. Or me to buy it again. But there you go, some print on the back of that panel. R2-D2 is the standard R2-D2 I think we've pretty much seen before, and I've got his head back to front, which is unforgivable. There we go, R2-D2. Standard little minifigure that we've seen before, and this was one of the better ones in the previous ones of years. You used to get a print just high up on the dome, but now it's fully covering that part. So, shame there's nothing on the back. There we go. On R2-D2. So, the other two figures in the pack, one is a Sand Trooper, which comes with a small silver stud. And that's supposed to replicate the Luxor droids, the piece that they find in the desert. Standard backpack, which we've seen on Sand Trooper minifigs in the past. It's a couple of basically lightsaber-like pieces plugged onto his back over that L-shaped bracket. Standard blaster. These are brand new pauldrons that have never been printed before. There's still that cloth material, but still pretty good nonetheless. And that gives him that white pauldron. If I take the helmet off, you'll notice that, as per our previous LEGO reviews, Stormtroopers now have underneath the helmet, they have the correct kind of black balaclava-like thing around the face, and they've got a little bit of stubble there. So, what is nice if you look in more detail is the attempt, I'll put the helmet back on, show you that, is the attention to detail on the sand that's been added. You can see the duct that's been put around this sand tripper there. And also, it's a brand new torso print that he's got. It's a completely different print on that main torso piece that that minifigure has. And also, pretty rare in the past, we have had some figures that have had it, but nice to see it is the Stormtrooper knees and the print for the feet and so forth. So just adds a nice touch. Now let me just show you, there is some difference in print on the back, I believe. It's again a brand new print that we've not had before. So slight variation on the print on the back, but again the duct's been added too, so we've got an all-round cool as sand trooper. And you can see the way the pauldron's applied, it's just a twisty piece of material that wraps around, and that's pretty much how he's put together. Very simple, very easy to do, and a great little build, and it's probably the one reason that you want to buy this pack, I'd imagine, is to get hold of this sand trooper. Is that just me? I don't know. Let me know what you think. But that's Sand Trooper number one with the white pauldron. I believe that's the sergeant. I'm not quite sure. Sitting on top of this little speeder bike is the second Sand Trooper. And I'll just bring him around. Exactly the same figure. No difference whatsoever. The print is exactly the same. The backpack is exactly the same. It's the pauldron that's the difference. So there's nothing to differ from the previous Sand Trooper at all. You'll see the markings on the body are absolutely A1 spot identical. Nothing different. So there we go. I'm a sucker for orange for some reason, but it's a great looking figure. So again, one of those multiple packs I think you'll probably want to build up and get and update some of your older Sand Troopers and older figures that you've got kicking around. So a great little Sand Trooper guy. He sits on one of these cool little speeder bikes, and let me just put him back in here and I'll show you. Oops, I can get him to sit. I'll take his blaster off, there we go. Now this is a swoop bike, SWOOP. If you've read some of the Star Wars EU, this was generally a mode of transport around Tatooine, and in the EU there was characters like Dengar, who got in a race with Han Solo, and that's why he's disfigured and so forth. All sorts of stories about these swoops. But it was certainly around the Shadows of the Empire time that these kind of swoops came out. So again, a nice little touch of Lego to see that they're absolutely fans like us, and they've built this kind of cool nod to the Star Wars universe, just as a little extra vehicle in there to run around, even though the Sand Troopers wouldn't have used it, but never mind. Let's not get too anal about the Star Wars universe. It's a really cool vehicle, it's a really cool set. Nice little piece as well. It's not working too well here at the moment, but if you can add in your blasters to a clip at the back, it works on the smaller blasters, I think. There's two little holes there for blasters to go on to these figures, and you can run around with these blasters or macro binoculars or something, which is always in short supply. I wish they'd have included a set of macro binoculars, which would have just been ideal, which I think I'll have to customise. So there we go, another great little set from LEGO this year. They're really paying attention to some of the older sets, and this has been released before, but they've updated this massively. In terms of detail on those minifigures, it really is something else. 9490 Droid Escape is available pretty much everywhere. Certainly it's available here in Australia from Big W, our version of Target. I picked this one up for shopforme.com.au, a local store here, who gave me a really good price on that. Check their website for the latest prices. They have daily blitzes, and that's why the prices can vary at times, but you can snag a bargain. And also this is available from Chowren Toys, chowrentoys.com, our LEGO sponsor, the world's second largest LEGO store. And let me tell you, if you go and look in, you will see some really old and hard to find LEGO, as well as brand new sets. And you'll get to see the original version of this, which you might prefer. But some great sets. And some good fun to be had here, so let us know what you think. Is this a good set, bad set? Are the minifigures awful? Do you really want it or not? Let us know what you think. Comments below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net. And stay tuned and hit subscribe over there, and you'll get lots of cool videos pretty much every day so far of all lots of Star Wars stuff. LEGO and non-LEGO, Sideshow, Hasbro. We have a lot of stuff to review and coming, so hang with us. We'll get a break from LEGO if you're fed up with us. And we'll see you for some more reviews soon. Cheers.